Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Naughty Threats. In case you're new here, do consider subscribing and also hit the bell icon to get all the future updates. So in today's video, I'm going to share how to do this peacock feather design using double color. I know most of you guys must be thinking this is already uploaded, why am I doing this again? But yeah, there are slight changes. In the previous video when I worked, these were really close, they kind of overlapped on each other. But in this video, I've made those little changes so that these feathers sit one next to the other. And also, the way I worked pico in this video is different, and the pico stitch in the previous video is different. So watch till the end and do give it a try. Also, let me know in the comment section as to how you like it. Now, without any delay, let's get started. So this is the pallu and this is the body of the saree. So for the baseline, I'm going to use this color. I have taken 6 strands, made a knot, and along with that, I'm going to use my regular crochet needle number 10. So the right side of the pallu is facing on top, and I'm going to start with the baseline here. And then I'm going to work 5 chains. And 1 single crochet. Repeat the same thing 2 more times. So now I have 3 blocks of 5 chains. Next, I'm going to work 8 chains. And then 1 single crochet in the first chain. So that it forms a loop like this. Now we'll fix this loop right next to this single crochet we've already worked. So here is 1 single crochet. So this will be the base. Again, we'll have to work 5 chains 3 times. I have already posted this design in the past, but in that video I have worked 3 chains instead of 5 chains, and the arches are really close. So for this particular one, I wanted the arches to be a little away from each other. That is why I am increasing 2 chains in the baseline. So if you want it to overlap, then you can follow that video. In case you want little distance between the arches, you can follow this video. So after 3 blocks, I'm going to work 8 chains. And then the first single crochet in the first chain. And the next single crochet next to this one. It kind of looks funny right now, but once we finish the arch, you will understand. So at this stage, if you feel it is not going right, don't panic. If you have these loops like this, then you are going in the right track. So the same way, we will continue working the base till the end. I'll continue with 3 blocks of 5 chains and then a loop. Once we reach the end, we'll turn the saree and then continue the next step. So after reaching the end, I have turned the saree. I have kind of adjusted it in a way where, you know, I've got 3 blocks of 5 chains. So if you see, the distance here is little less and the distance here is slightly more. So I have just added one extra chains here and made sure it ends with 3 blocks, just like how we started. Now after you turn the sari, continue with 5 chains and 1 single crochet in the first block. Repeat the same thing, 5 chains, single crochet in the next block. Five chains and one single crochet again in the next block. So three times, five chains and single crochet. So now I have reached this loop and we'll start working our double crochets in this loop. So I've done 18 double crochets in total. And this is how it should look at this stage. So after 18 stitches, I'm going to fix this using a single crochet here and continue with 5 chains and single crochet. So now it will just be 2 blocks of 5 chains and single crochet, and then you will continue the same way throughout the sari. In this loop again work 18 double crochets. You might find it a little tricky while working double crochets here, especially the first double crochet. So the trick is to hold this loop with your other fingers and then work your double crochet. If you don't hold this, then it will kind of slip and this is how it will look. So if you start working double crochets from here, then this place will be empty. So just for one or two stitches, make sure you hold the loop with your finger like this and then work your stitches. So once you've done 2 or 3 stitches, then it should be fine. You can simply continue. So 18 stitches in each loop. Now fix it using a single crochet, 5 chains and single in the next block, 5 chains and single in the next block. This is how you will continue this step till the end of the sari. I finished working this round, reached the end and I've trimmed the thread. Now I'm going to join green as my second color. This is going to be our final step. Holding both together, I'm going to make a couple of knots. And then we'll continue working on the same step. I'm going to start from this one, inside this single crochet. 5 chains, 1 single crochet in the next block. And then I'm going to work double crochets on every double crochet followed by a picot stitch. So this is one double crochet. I'm going to work 3 chains and fix this 3 chain below this double crochet by using a single crochet. So this will become a picot stitch. If you want, you can actually do or work a picot stitch by working 3 chains and then passing it from this first chain, pull a loop, come out and then pass through both. But once you fix this, both are going to look identical, so I am just saving time by just working 3 chains and fixing it using a single crochet. So 3 chains and 1 single crochet here below the double. So same way you will have to continue on each and every double crochet. But while working this step, make sure the length of the double crochet is even. If you work one stitch longer and the other shorter, then it might not look nice. So just double check the length while working your doubles. I finished working the double crochets in every stitch and I've reached the end here. Now just for the last stitch, I have stopped with double crochet. I am not going to do a picot stitch after the double crochet. And I'm going to fix this using a single crochet here in the very next block. And then I'm going to work one single crochet in the previous single crochet. And then one single crochet in the next block. If you want, you can add a hanging or a bead or anything of your choice here where we are working 3 singles. But for this particular saree, I didn't want to add any beads, so I am not adding it. Then you will simply continue with double crochets followed by a picot stitch. So this is how we will continue working on all the arches, and once we reach the end, the design is complete. So this is a shortcut method of working 2 steps in 1 single step. Because we are working picot followed by every double crochet, there is no need to work one more step. So this method will definitely save time. So this is a bright parrot green pallu with the small gold zari butas. So that is why I chose this kind of design, and I did not use any beads because I didn't want to. And the body of the sari is this color, and it also has these kind of floral butas all over. It's just 2 colors with no border. That's how the sari is, and this is the design. So once complete, this is how it will look. So I guess that's about it in today's video. In case you like the video, do give us a thumbs up, and do let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Don't forget to check out our blog naughtythreads.net, which is there on the screen right now. I guess I shall see you soon with more interesting videos. Until then, take care, guys, and bye bye.